Good morning, students. So in the last class we have discussed about the soldering, brazing and applications of soldering and brazing, right? And advantages and disadvantages. And today we are going to discussing about the different types of flame cuttings, principles of flame cutting, method of flame cutting, equipments used in flame cutting, types of flame cutting, advantages, applications, and also defects in welding process. Okay, so these are the points we are going to discuss in today's class. First of all, we are going to know the what is flame cutting. So it is the method of cutting metals using oxy fuel gas. This is the method of cutting metals using oxy fuel gas. So in the diagram we are observing the flame cutting here. So completely we are doing cutting operation, right? We are not doing welding. Welding means joining. Here removing the material or cut the two parts. That's why it is a flame cutting operation. So principle of flame cutting is based on that oxygen has a strong affinity for iron and steel at elevated temperature. So this action being is less at low temperature. At higher temperatures, oxygen forms iron oxide with iron, which has low melting temperature. And at high temperatures, it melts out and the metal is cut. Okay, so this is the principle of flame cutting. So the principle is based on that oxygen has a strong affinity for iron and steel at elevated temperature. That means high temperatures. So, but the action, the flame cutting operation is being is less at low temperature. The action performing of flame cutting is less at low temperatures. So we need high temperatures for doing the cutting operation. So what happening at high temperatures? At high temperatures, oxygen forms iron oxide, that means rust, with iron, which has low melting temperature. And at high temperatures, it melts out and the metal is cut. In this way, the metal cutting operation has been performed by doing the flame cutting, right? At high temperatures, oxygen forms iron oxide with iron, which has low melting temperature. Iron oxide, that means rust, it has low melting temperature. And at high temperatures, it's melt out and the metal is being cut. Purposes of flame cutting. So during many manufacturing processes, it is often necessary to cut metals to size and to shape their edges. So what is the purpose of flame cutting? In many manufacturing process, it is often necessary to cut metals to size. So if you want to make the metals to a desired size or to shape their edges, like you are listening about chamfering operation, like that operations, or to cut the metals to desired shape. So for this reason, we need a flame cutting operation. And the flame cutting operation has been performed at high temperatures. At high temperatures, iron oxygen is reacted with iron and makes iron oxide. That means it is a rust. That rust has low melting temperature. So due to this high temperatures, the metal is cut from the material, right? And the oxyacetylene flame can be used for cutting steel plates. Here different types of flames are also there. The oxyacetylene, in this oxygen and acetylene flame can be used for cutting steel plates also. Next, method of flame cutting. So the blow pipe is the equipment. In the diagram we have observed the blow pipe, that means it is a cutting torch is the equipment used for cutting, and it supplies mixture of oxygen and acetylene through its outer orifice to produce flame for preheating steel, that is at 900 degrees centigrade. So then oxygen is released through its central orifice to strike the preheated steel and to oxidize it. Oxide has a low melting point. It is blown away by the force of jet, leaving a clean cut. Right? The blowpipe is the equipment used for cutting, and this blowpipe supplies mixture of oxygen and acetylene through its outer orifice to produce flame for preheating steel 900 degrees centigrade. Then oxygen is released. First, acetylene is released and preheat the material. After that, oxygen is released through its central orifice to strike the preheated steel to oxidize it. Oxide has low melting point. It is blown away by the force of jet, leaving a clean cut. So oxygen cutting is performed by ordinary gas welding equipment, except that welding torch is replaced by cutting torch. So flame cutting, if we are using oxygen cutting, it is performed by ordinary gas welding equipment, that welding torch is replaced by cutting torch. So here the two torches are there, that is, one is welding torch and another one is cutting torch. Types of flame cuttings. As we know already, the different types of flame cuttings also exist. In that, the first one is acetylene flame cutting, powder cutting, oxygen lamps cutting, arc cutting. So in that, we are going to discussing about the powder cutting, because it is similar to acetylene cutting process. In this process, iron powder is injected into oxygen jet during cutting. The powder is oxidized by oxygen jet and it releases considerable amount of heat and auxiliary in the cutting process. So this method does not require preheating. So observe here the powder, iron powder cutting. How the method is doing, once again we are going to discuss. In this process, iron powder is injected into oxygen jet during cutting, and the powder is oxidized by oxygen jet and it releases considerable amount of heat and accelerate cutting process. And this type of process does not require preheating. Next, oxygen lamps cutting. In oxygen lamps cutting, it is a process by which holes are pierced in heavy blocks of metals by a jet of oxygen passing through a steel pipe called lamps. So a preheating flame separately helps and a stream of oxygen is passed through it. So observe here. So it is a sheet. On this sheet, we have to produce the holes. Piercing means what? We are going to produce the holes, right? So how the method is running? It is a cutting by which holes are pierced in heavy blocks of metals by a jet of oxygen passing through a steel pipe. Jet of oxygen. Jet means what? Which the speed is high for the fluids is called jet. High speed fluids are called jet. Okay, jet of oxygen passing through a steel pipe called lamps. A preheating flame separately helps and a stream of oxygen passed through it. Next, the method, last, arc cutting. In this method of arc cutting, a tubular electrode is used and a stream of oxygen passes through the electrode, right? A tubular electrode is used, right? So like arc cutting, and a stream of oxygen passed through this electrode. Tubular means it is a hollow electrode, and some of the oxygen, stream of oxygen passed through this electrode. The oxygen assists the cutting by oxidizing and blowing away molten metal. It is less efficient and inferior to flame cutting. So metals which can be cut by using a flame cutting process are carbon steels, low alloy steels, high alloy steels. Metals which cannot be effectively cut by this process, cast iron. The melting point of cast iron is 1200 degrees centigrade. Advantages with flame cutting: this process is quick and does not require power, and it produces straight and profile cuts can easily be made in ferrous metals. Two or more plates placed one above the other can be cut at a time using single torch. And limitations: clean cut profiles cannot be obtained on non-ferrous metals because iron oxide is produced while doing the cutting operation, and surface finish is also rough. Accuracy and precision are inferior compared to machining process. Applications: it can be used for cutting up large plates into particular shapes, cutting up broken or worn out equipment, for producing the chamfered edges for welding joints, and it is very useful for rapid removal of excess metal from large castings. Okay, so with this we have concluded that flame cutting operation is generally used for cutting the metals. How the what is the basic principle of flame cutting? So oxygen is reacted with the metals and it produces iron oxide, which has low melting temperature, but with welding torch we are providing high temperature. So due to this high temperatures, that iron oxide, that means rust, is melted and cutting off from the material. So generally flame cutting operations are used for providing desired shape while doing the cutting operations. Okay, so now the next topic is defects in welding and testing and inspection of weldments. Okay, so here the welding defect, observe here the joint, two materials here. This is one of the welding defect. So different types of welding defects are occurred while doing the welding operation. So now we have to observe that what are the welding defects. So most common defects in welding are lack of penetration, undercut, slag inclusion, porosity, weld crack, spatter, poor fusion, warping and distortion. Okay, so these are the welding defects occurred during the welding operations. So we are going to discussing one by one. Lack of penetration and misalignment. So in the diagram you can observe the lack of penetration and misalignment. Here observing the perfect joint is not appeared here. So two parts are appeared separately. Here the joint is not made perfectly. Okay, so that means lack of penetration and misalignment. And it is a weld undercut. It's a weld undercut operation defect. So lack of penetration means actually entering the parent metal caused by too long an arc length. Okay, so lack of weld metal actually entering the parent metal. It has to be, the weld metal has to be entering into the gap between the two metals, but it does not enter between the two metals gap. how, why it is happened means it is caused by too long an arc length. If the arc length is too long, these defects may be appeared and undercut. Here the groove formed along the edges of welding bead. This is caused due to excessive current, excessive speed, and wrong electrode position. Here the groove. Groove formed along the edges of welding bead, and it is caused due to excessive current, excessive speed, and wrong electrode position. Welding defects. Slag inclusion. Mixing of slag or other foreign matter actually inside the weld metal. So this is due to caused inadequate slag removal between runs or electrode replace. If we are not removing the unmounted material from the two workpieces, that may be included in welding operation. So due to this, the slag inclusion defect may be occurred. So mixing of slag or other foreign matter actually inside the weld metal. It is caused due to inadequate slag removal between runs or electrode replace. Porosity. Hole in the weld metal. So if the holes are produced in the weld bead, that defect is called porosity. It is due to the wrong type of electrode. Holes in the weld metal caused by the mixing of gas. While doing the operation, welding joint, the gases are mixed in this welding process. Due to this welding, mixing of gases in the weld bead, the holes are produced in the weld bead. So it has to be done due to the wrong type of electrode. And discontinuities in the weld zone is called weld crack. Generally results from stresses caused by the expansion and contraction. And spatter. So some of the materials while doing the welding operation, the chips are expelled from the electrode and deposited on the surface of the parent metal. So this can be removed by the chipping hammer. Okay, so it is caused by damped welding conditions or incorrect heat input. Globules of metals expelled from an electrode and deposited on the surface of the parent metal. So it is caused by damped welding conditions or incorrect heat input. So these are the spatters. So they are removed by the chipping hammer. So while doing this operation, the electrode particles are expelled and stick onto the surface of the parent metal. So those are called spatters, and that can be removed by the chipping hammer. Lack of thorough and complete mixing between filler metal and base metal. It is caused due to faulty technique, warping and distortion, deviations of weldments from straightness or flatness. Straight ga undakunda, flat ga undakunda, deviation aithe, that is called warping and distortion because of improper welding fixtures. So this is the straight, this is warping and distortion. Actually the operation is performed here, has to be performed here. Welding defects. So this is a welding crack, undercuts, porosity and spatter, slag inclusions, cracks, warping and distortion. Weld crack. And next, coming to the testing and inspection of welding zone. So Non-destructive tests used for detecting defects in weldments, that is visual inspection, radiography test, ultrasonic test and magnetic test, liquid penetration test. Visual inspection, by seeing this we can tell that it has is having these defects. Those defects are undercuts, surface blowholes, cracks, dimensional errors. And a radiography test, it is based on the different absorption of radiation, it is X-ray or virus passing through the work. This method reveals porosity, cracks, pore fusion and slag inclusion. Next, ultrasonic test. Due to signals, we can tell that what are the defects appeared in this welding bead. So next, liquid penetration test, indication, magnetic particle test. So this is radiography test. Ultrasonic waves are passed through the workpiece and the waves reflected from the defect and the opposite face produce the electrical impulses which are fed into a cathode ray oscilloscope to study the defect. And next, magnetic test reveals the surface defects due to dispersion of magnetic flux at the defect. This method is used to defect in fine cracks and holes in the weld. And the last one, liquid penetration test, it is used to reveal the fine cracks. Okay, so with this I have concluded the defects in welding process and also flame cutting operations, right? Thank you.